People like resolution in life and in stories. When Christopher Nolan left us with an inconclusive ending to Inception, we didn't want to accept it. Instead, we became convinced that there must be an ending, and if we can just piece all the clues together, if we looked hard enough, we could see it. But this film is not a puzzle, and it has no hidden totems. The film is a comment on our perception of reality and the inevitable uncertainty that goes along with that. The uncertain ending of the film reinforces this comment.
No, she is not real.
How do you know that?
One of the very first images we see of Cobb is him displaying his wedding ring in a dream. Then, throughout the movie, we can see that Cobb wears a ring in dreams, but not in reality. All of this attention to his ring certainly gives weight that the ring has meaning. But his ring is not his totem, and it does not give a conclusive ending to the movie. Cobb never holds or wears his ring in reality, because his ring is not a physical object like a totem needs to be. His ring appears in his dreams as a projection of his subconscious, because with refusing to accept Maul's death, Cobb is losing touch with what reality is.
They come to be woken up. The dream has become the reality.
Cobb's goal is to get home to his children. Cobb never sees the faces of his children in his dreams because he knows that they are not really his children, but rather just projections of his subconscious.
Those aren't my children.
You keep telling yourself that, but you don't believe
it. No, I know it.
If Cobb wants to see his children, he needs to accept Maul's death and say goodbye to her. His subconscious projection of his wedding ring in his dreams symbolizes this internal conflict, making Cobb choose between dreaming of his wife or being with his children. The ring does tell us one other thing. Without the ring, it could be argued that the entire movie was just a dream of Cobb's, one that he had on the plane. But with the ring, we see that Cobb was intertwined in dreams and reality throughout the movie. The top is Cobb's totem. We see him use it 3 times throughout the movie to test reality. And the 2 times we watch it come to a stop, we see his relief in knowing that his totem has passed the test. We also see the top spin in dreams. Cobb starts it spinning in the safe, knowing that it will spin forever, in order to prove to Maul, who locked the top away so she could forget they were dreaming, that they are living a dream and need to head to the train tracks. Santo gives it a spin in the opening scene, and it continues to spin through their entire conversation with no sign of stopping. Seeing that Cobb turns to the top for his own sanity and being shown that it works as it should in reality and in dreams clearly shows that the top is Cobb's true totem. This is not the final scene of the movie. In the final scene, we only get a glimpse of Cobb's hand, and we cannot confirm if he is wearing the ring or not. What we can confirm is that Cobb sees his children's faces. He has made it home to them in one reality or another. It doesn't matter which one. This inconclusive ending to a film that questions our perception of reality is very fitting, because like the ending of the film, we can never be certain what our own reality actually is.